guys, welcome back to WixFix. I hope you're having a fantastic day. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to add these amazing animated icons to your website using Lordicon. Now, I'm not sponsored by Lordicon, but the team over there was generous enough to give you guys 20% off their pro plan. They have hundreds of free icons to use, but the pro plan comes with over 1,000 more icons and more downloadable options. Lordicon is perfect for business owners trying to make an awesome website for their business, and it's also perfect for freelancers and agencies that make several websites for their clients. So if you like what you see in this video, be sure to click the link in the description and use code WixFix at checkout to get 20% off. Let's go ahead and get started. With Wix's library of icons, I feel their icons are pretty basic and inconsistent. It's like they hired several designers to create 10 icons each. So if you want a specific icon on your site, then you may run into issues finding icons that match the style you're going for. That's typically the reason I never use icons in Wix. However, with Lordicon, not only are all the icons animated, and not only are all the icon styles consistent, but you can also customize the icons to be exactly what you need. You can change both the primary and secondary colors, the stroke widths, the size, you can change the animation trigger for each icon. And if that wasn't enough, in this video, you will see just how easy Lordicon made it to add these icons to your Wix websites. So if we take a look at the section I made in Editor X, I want to add some icons in these boxes above the small titles. If you want to see how I made this section in Editor X, be sure to comment below and I may make a tutorial on that in the future. Also, before I get too far in this video, I want to mention that the process for adding icons to an Editor X site is basically the exact same for the classic editor. But the first thing we actually need to do is go to Lordicon's website. The link to that will be in the description below. Now that we're on the site, we can press Browse Icons. Here we can find icons we want to use for the site. We can hover or click on an icon to preview the animation. Once we find the icon that we want, we can press Reveal Full Editor at the bottom right of the screen. Here we can easily change the primary and secondary colors for the icons. If you have a specific color you want to use, then you can input the hex code for that color and press Add to Palette. This will save the color to your account for future use. Under the color, you can set a stroke width to be exactly what you need. On the right-hand side of the icon editor, you can see a drop-down to change the trigger. You can choose Hover, which activates the animation when the user moves their cursor over the icon. Another option is Loop. This is especially good for loading icons. The next option is Loop on Hover. Pretty self-explanatory, but when the user hovers their cursor over the icon, then the animation loops until the user stops hovering over the icon. Lastly, you can also select Morph. For this trigger, when a user hovers over or clicks the icon, it will start the animation. But when the user stops hovering or clicks off the icon, then the animation will animate in reverse. This is perfect for icons like this setting slider icon. If you scroll down a little bit, then you can see the preview section. Here you can see real-world applications for the icons and see exactly what it would look like on your site. Once you're happy with the design, we can then come over to the download section. Here you can download the JSON file, the After Effects file, a GIF, and other source files. For this example, we will just be using the embed HTML. Once you click this option, we can make a couple last-second adjustments to the size and trigger, and then we can press Copy HTML code. Now it's time to go back to Wix. The next step is to add an element to our website that allows us to insert some code. So if we go up to Add, you can either add the HTML iframe from the Quick Add menu, or go down to Embed and Social and drag out Embed widget to your site. In the classic editor, you will go to Add, go down to Embed, and select Embed a Widget. Now in both editors, you can press Enter code and paste in the Lordicon code using Command V or Control V on PC. Lastly, press Update and Apply to see the icon right in the editor. If the icon is too big or too small, then there are two ways to change it. You can either go back to Lordicon, press Embed HTML, change the size to be whatever you need, then go back to Wix and replace the code in the Embed widget. Or you can manually edit the code by pressing Edit Code, go down to Style, and here you can edit the width and height of the icon in pixels. Now that the icon isn't too large, we can adjust the embed widget size so it's not too large. And the cool thing about Editor X is we can easily put the embed widget into a stack. So let's go ahead and place the icon in the container right above the text. We'll go ahead and select the stack or the content in the stack. We'll press unstack. Then we'll make sure everything is selected, including the icon, and press stack. Now the icon is grouped with the other elements, and when we go through the process of making the website responsive, these elements will remain together and should hold their shape. If you want smaller icons for smaller screen sizes, here are some steps that you can take for other breakpoints. Unfortunately, if you go to another screen size like the tablet view and just try to edit the code, the icon size will change for all the screen sizes. At this time, Editor X does not support different codes for different screen sizes. So instead, just copy and paste the embed widget for each breakpoint. In each one of these copies, press Edit Code and manually change the size of the icon to the size you need it to be. Next, in the layer panel, double-click the icons and name them for desktop, tablet, and mobile. Then grab all the icons and all the other content and press stack. Now on desktop, open up the layer panel, find the icons that are for the other breakpoints, press the three little dots, and press don't display. Then go over to the smaller breakpoints like tablet, right click on the bigger desktop icon and press don't display. Then you need to show the smaller tablet icon by clicking the little eyeball in the layer panel to show it on the page. Then just edit the tablet view however you would like. For mobile, we'll basically be following the same exact steps. We will press don't display on the tablet icon, press the eyeball for the mobile icon in the layer panel, and edit the mobile site to look presentable. So as you can see, Lordicon is an amazing tool to make your website look even more high class, custom, and professional. I'm currently working on a brand new Wix Fix site in Editor X, and I can guarantee that I will be using some of these icons in the new design. And before I wrap up the video, I just want to say that only about 13% of you are subscribed. I would love to reach 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year, so if you enjoy the tutorials and videos, please consider subscribing for more content like this. But that basically wraps it up for the video today. If you are interested in getting 20% off the Pro plan, be sure to use the link in the description and use code WIXFIX at checkout. Thank you for watching, and if you found this tutorial useful or cool, please like the video because it helps the channel grow. Thank you again, and I'll see you on the next one.